entire group of members of press in South Korea got to see the first 20 minutes of Avengers Endgame. One of them have made notes regarding the first 20 minutes, and we're going to talk about it today and try to break it down. Stick around. What's good? Welcome back to the channel.
Fist bump.
If you're new to the channel, then do this. Express your zest in knowing more about the MCU and diving through the pages of Stan Lee's great comics by subscribing and hitting the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of our uploads. This is our Avengers Endgame playlist where you can get major Avengers Endgame questions answered. Click on the card here and it'll take you there. Alright, so the opening scene, we see Hawkeye on his farm teaching archery to his daughter, and when he turns around, he realizes that she's disappeared along with the rest of the family. This is of course the result of Thanos' snap, and this leads Hawkeye to exile himself in Japan as Ronin. Then we switch to Wakanda, where the Wakandans are mourning the losses of all their loved ones, especially King T'Challa. So then all the remaining Avengers who fought in Wakanda get to Shuri's lab where she was trying to mend Vision, and there everyone's repenting what they did. Rocket is holding back his tears, and Thor said that he almost had Thanos, but he let him go, thanks to his fault that he did not go for the head. And then Rhodey is in silence, and Bruce Banner is repenting the same thing, and Cap says that it's no one's fault, and Rhodey says that it doesn't matter now, we lost. So they've all given up on what they could have done. And then we shift to Tony Stark and Nebula, who are on the Benatar. Now Tony Stark is having a dream wherein he's marrying Pepper Potts, but she slowly disappears away as a result of Thanos' snap. He then wakes up with great fear. Then the author has also mentioned that Tony Stark and Nebula spend their time by playing games in the ship and even repairing it. And he also stated that back on Earth in New York City, many looters and protesters are taking it to the streets, and people have biblical verse on signs and they're protesting with it. And the author says, save Thor and Rocket. Now we don't exactly know by what he means, but we have to wait for the movie to get this answer. The Avengers then go back to the Avengers HQ, and they then receive an energy spike, a distress call, which is nothing but from Tony Stark. We also see Thor meeting Captain Marvel, which we have already seen in the trailers. And then we get to see what Tony Stark was doing, that is recording the message. And during the message, he jokes about stealing Peter Quill's clothes and his resources to survive on the ship. And he states that all of them disappeared in front of his eyes, and he feels really sorry for them, especially for Peter Parker. So this was the entire 20-minute footage that was shown. And if you guys enjoy short daily uploads coming out on Marvel, which are short, thus giving your answers as quick as possible, then consider subscribing by going for the head, and do not forget to click on either of these videos to continue watching. I still believe in superheroes. Do you?